Now let's talk about something which is very unique, escape speed. So what happens is when you throw a stone in upward direction, it will come down. So when you throw it with higher velocity, it will go further up, but again, it will come down. Okay. So escape speed is the minimum value of the speed which is required, okay, to leave the Earth gravitational pull. So what will happen is that the mass will just go to infinity. It will not come back. Okay. And it does not matter at what angle you throw it. Okay. So even if you throw it horizontally from the Earth's surface from here, it will slowly go till infinity if you throw it with that speed. Fine. So we need to find out what is that minimum speed with which if I throw an object, it will go to the infinity or it will reach the infinity. Okay. Let's say that minimum velocity is V. All right. Radius of the Earth is Re. Okay. Mass of the Earth is capital M, and mass of this object is also supposed given small m. Fine. Now, can you find out what is the minimum velocity which is required by this mass to reach the infinity? The hint is, try using work energy theorem. Potential energy when the object reaches at infinity is zero. Okay. But potential will be there when the mass is at the surface of Earth and you're launching it, it will have some potential energy. The work done will be zero because there is no other external force other than gravity. Okay. And for gravity force, you are anyway considering the potential energy. So you will not double count it when you talk about the work done. So work done is zero. Okay. K2 is what? When the point number two is infinity, point number one is surface of the Earth. Okay. So at infinity, kinetic energy is zero. It has just reached the infinity. All right. Now U2 is what? All of you quickly tell me. U2 is what? When the object reaches infinity, what will be the potential energy between small m and the capital M? It will be zero. Okay. K1 is what? Kinetic energy initially, which is half m into v square. All right. And U1? U1 is minus of g m m by radius of Earth. Okay. Now, just substitute the values. When you substitute the values, you'll see that everything else is zero. So these two terms, when you equate to zero, small m get cancelled. So you will have half times v square to be equal to g m by r e. All right. So from here, v is equal to under root of 2 g m by r e. Fine. Now we know that gm by re square, this is acceleration due to gravity. Fine. So you can also write this term as root 2 gre. Same thing, because g is this, you can write this as like that. Right. So when you substitute all the values, you will get escape velocity to be equal to 11.2 kilometers per second. Fine. So if you throw an object with that velocity, okay, you throw an object with that velocity, the object will not be able to come back. The object won't be able to come back. Fine. All of you clear, right? Fine. So let us take a numerical on whatever we have learned just now. In fact, this is from your NCERT book itself. Okay, so here goes the numerical. This question came in 1997 JEE Advanced. Okay, so I think after that only NCERT has adopted this question in the textbook. It's a nice question. All of you draw the diagram with me. Radius is R. Okay. The mass over here is M, and here the mass is 4M. The center to center distance. Is 6R. Okay. The question goes like this. You have a mass small m. Mass small m is there, kept on the surface of the first sphere. Okay, it is kept on the surface of the first sphere. It is projected from the surface with velocity v. It is projected with velocity v from the surface. You need to find the minimum velocity v. You need to find minimum velocity v for which the mass m can reach the other sphere 4m. Okay, so these are the two spheres kept at a distance of 6r. Small m mass is projected from the first sphere. You need to find minimum velocity v for which the small m can reach the other sphere. Try to do this your own. All of you tried. Ajay, tell me what will be the condition for minimum velocity. Okay. What will be the condition? Will the minimum velocity will be such that when it reaches the other sphere, the velocity becomes zero? Is that what will be the condition for minimum velocity? Is the minimum velocity, guys, I'm asking you something. The condition for minimum velocity is what? Simple question. The condition for minimum velocity is what? Is the minimum velocity that velocity for which it reaches the other sphere with zero velocity? It just reaches the other sphere. Is that the condition for minimum velocity? First answer me that. Is that the condition for minimum velocity? So Niranjan, how you got that answer? That is wrong then. You can't get that answer using that. Why that is not the condition? Why that is not the condition? The question is that for minimum velocity, what is the condition? All right. Is this the condition that minimum velocity is that velocity for which it just reaches the second sphere? When it reaches the second sphere, velocity becomes zero. Okay. Why that is not the condition? Why this is not the condition? Okay. Can this ever happen? Can this ever happen? that when it reaches the other sphere, its velocity is just becoming zero. It can never happen. Okay, it's like you're falling from the sky, and when you are about to reach the earth, your velocity becomes zero. Okay, it's absurd. It will never happen. Okay, so you need to understand one thing, that this mass is under the influence of two gravity. Okay, the one gravity, one sphere is trying to pull it this way, the other one is trying to pull it that way. Okay, so if let's say this is F1 and this is F2, okay, if F1 is greater than F2, all right, if F1 is greater than F2, then it will automatically attract this mass M. Even if this mass somehow reaches this sphere, but since F1 is greater than M2, as soon as it hits this sphere, it'll come back because F1 is greater than F2 all the while. Okay, so if this is valid for entire path from this point to that point, then this situation will never happen because it will ultimately get pulled back on the first sphere. Okay, but if F1 becomes equal to F2 in between, and that point onwards, F2 becomes greater than F1, because you know forces of gravitation depends on the distance. So closer the mass reaches near the second sphere, the larger the force of the second sphere will be. So this force will slowly increase and this force will slowly decrease. So there will be a point when these two forces become equal, and after that point onwards, F2 will become greater than F1. So if you cross that point, even if your velocity is zero, this mass will automatically pull that mass inside. Okay, so basically the velocity should become zero where F1 is equal to F2. And after that point onwards, the second sphere will anyway pull it towards itself. Understood? All of you understood? Now, the first step is to find the point where F1 become equal to F2. All right. Now, F1 is what? F1 is GMM divided by, let's say, R square. Small r is a distance where the forces are balanced. So let's say this is small r. Okay. This when become equal to G. Now capital M is 4M into small m divided by 6R minus R the whole square. Right? So when you equate the forces, you get a point where the four gravitation forces are balanced. All right. And what is that point? You'll solve this expression, you'll get 6R minus R is equal to plus minus 2R. Okay, so you will get R to be equal to 2R. Understood? Is there any doubt till now? Any doubt? This is actually an advanced level question. Not sure what it is doing in NCRT, but good to see such question in NCRT. Okay, so I have got a point which should be at a distance of 2R from the center of the first sphere where the velocity should become zero. Okay, so I can use this work energy theorem between the initial point and the final point. Okay, so fine. The work done is zero. What else is zero? K2 is zero. When it reaches that point, R is equal to 2R. All right. Now, K1 is half M into V square. All right. U1 is what? U1 is potential energy between small m and capital M. plus potential energy between small m and 4m. Okay, so this is potential energy. You need to add it up at point one. Okay, at point one, potential energy between small m and capital M is GMM by the radius r. Okay, minus of GM into 4m divided by what? Quickly tell me. This divided by what? What is the distance between small m and the second sphere? How much it is? Look at the diagram. 5r, right? So from center, from here till this point, the distance is 5r. Distance is 5r. From center, you need to measure the distances. Okay. So this is 5r. All right. Now U2 is what? U2 is again potential energy between small m and capital M plus potential energy between small m and 4m when the particle reaches at point 2. Point 2 is at a distance of 2 times capital R from the center of the first sphere. So potential energy between small m and capital M is minus of GMM divided by 2r. Okay. And then potential energy between small m and capital M will be what? GM into 4m divided by what? Quickly tell me. Divide by what will come over here? Distance 4r. Okay. You're getting distances wrong. All right. So just substitute these values, you'll get the answer. Okay. So these kind of questions, these are a little bit involved question. You're not expected to solve these questions right from where you have learned the concept, and you will not be able to immediately start solving these kind of questions. Although this is a solved problem, so if you have book open in front of you, you can easily refer to that. Okay, but I don't expect you to get it immediately after learning a concept. So you may not get such kind of questions in school exams, but then since it's a part of your solved exercise in your NCRT, I thought of taking it up.